Now let's quickly talk about the telescope. You get two types of telescopes, a refracting telescope. Refracting, that tells you we are going through two lenses. You get reflecting, whereby the objective lens is replaced by a concave mirror. And then the refractive is that with these two lenses, there's an equation for the angle of magnification, the objective lens, the eyepiece lens, and just the negative in front of them. Now, we do view them as two thin lenses, but in actual fact, it's a compound lens system, both of them. These lenses, number one, are not thin lenses. Number two is their surfaces are not spherical, because if they were, you get something called spherical aberration. Remember, the refracting index for different wavelengths of light is different. So if they were just normal glass, thin glass lenses, you get chromatic aberration, as the light of different wavelengths get refracted by different angles. So it's certainly not as simple as we make it. You might be given a problem where you just given the objective and the eyepiece focal length, you can work out the angle of magnification. But what if you're told that it's a reflecting lens, and now you have a radius for the concave mirror? No problem. We remember that f equals negative r over 2. That is going to give us a half of that, which is a 120, which is a 125, and we're going to replace that with the fact that f1 equals 125 centimeters, and now we're just going to have that the magnification is going to be negative 125 divided by this 5, and that's going to be equal to negative 25. It's going to be that magnification. Now here's a compound system problem that this has a little bit of a twist in it, and you should not get run over by this little twist. I have a converging lens. I have a converging lens, central axis. It has a focal distance of 8 centimeters, so somewhere down there is the focal distance. I place an object at 40 centimeters, somewhere here I place my object. And 30 centimeters from here I have a plane mirror. So instead of two lenses, I have a plane mirror and I have this lens. What are all the images that are formed? Well, first of all, we're going to have an inverted real image on this side. And I'm going to get that from 1 over S0 equals 1 plus 1 over SI is going to be 1 over F. And that gives me an SI of, what did I get? SI of 10 centimeters. So at 10 centimeters, I'm going to get my first image, and it's going to be inverted here. Now, if this is 10 centimeters, and this is 30 centimeters, this means this must be 20 centimeters. So, I'm going to get, with no magnification, still inverted 20 centimeters on this side. I'm going to get this virtual image. Okay, which this lens is now going to see as a real object. Okay, and now don't get confused, because we've always placed the object on the left hand side. This is now not going to be an S0 of, and this is 20, this is 30, so I'm talking, this is at 50 centimeters, but that's not a negative 50 centimeters. Just flip the thing over in your mind. Okay, just flip the thing over in your mind, as if this is all to the left. So this is, the lens is going to see this as a real object with an SO of 1 over SO of 50 centimeters plus 1 over SI is going to be 1 over, it still has a focal distance of 8 centimeters. And that will give me an SI of I think I got 9.5, somewhere there about 9.5 centimeters of 9.5 centimeters. And so that is going to be on this side, the opposite side of this, and I'm seeing this as a positive 50. Okay, and it's going to be, because it's a real image, because it's on the opposite side of the object, and this is seen as a real object, it has also got to be inverted, so it's got to stand, it'll stand upright as far as that's concerned. So I'm going to get this real, image, I'm going to get this virtual image, which is then going to give me this back to this real image on this side, because this virtual image actually then acts as a real object. Okay, so you're going to get all of those images.